Fellas, in this video we're gonna revisit a classic of this channel, but we are gonna remix it a bit, in order to make it feel like another build. This is an Spectral Shield through Gladiator, but our DPS comes from Corrupting Fever. And since I didn't post a prelude to this one, we're just gonna go with the full send from Zero to Hero. I've got Ultimatum gameplay, Cortex, Maven, a tier 11 Trial Master that I found while leveling, and also Sirius. Though this last one didn't want to cooperate, so he got me once. Sometimes he do be like that. But anyways, this build is quite a refreshing take on a build that I've enjoyed throughout multiple leagues. We are technically a half-casting, half-shield-throwing gladiator. But there is an added degree of challenge to this build, because we are not relying on a Spectral Shield throw to damage enemies directly. The job of the skill is applying the Corrupting Blood debuff, so the bulk of our passives, currency and gear investments are gonna go into supporting and improving Corrupting Fever. But there is also a certain rhythm to this build. Corrupting Fever's initial cast is going to cost a hefty chunk of life, and even more so once it's 6 linked. The skill demands constant life spending to remain active, so in order to maintain the duration of this spell, we are gonna link every active skill to life tap. Now, obviously this doesn't apply to auras, because that will break our character, but for DPS and quality of life purposes, everything else needs to be linked to life tap, which is why you gotta keep spamming skills, even if you're out of danger. You don't really want to recast Corrupting Fever constantly. Having said that, I am a bit conflicted at the investment required to make this work. And I say this because I continuously made changes to it in order to squeeze as much damage as possible, which kinda made things expensive on my end. But the finished product should be relatively accessible, granted not super cheap, but manageable. But before I spoil more of this character, hey, if you are new around here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, a rating and a comment are always appreciated. And now, let us talk about putting together a caster gladiator, or as close to that as possible. Alright everyone, you all know the drill. Our first piece of equipment is going to be a Warlord or Shaper influenced chest piece, with plus 1 level of Socket active gems and plus 1 level of Socket strength gems. This is going to require faceted fossils, so get ready to burn some currency making this roulette work. Also, as much life and resistances as possible on it will be optimal. The weapon is a cold iron point with damage over time as the corrupted implicit. Now yes, a rare wand with both physical spell gem levels and all spell gem levels alongside damage over time multiplier should be superior, but this dagger with the corrupted implicit is a bit more realistic to acquire, also cheaper, hence why the weapon of choice is this guy. The shield has life, a resist or 2, plus 1 level of all physical spell skill gems and plus 2 minimum frenzy charges. The helmet has life, nearby enemies take increased physical damage, resistances, and we also need Corrupting Fever duration as the enchantment. This is mandatory because we want to make the spell last longer, both for upkeep time but also for the debuff we apply on enemies, especially since we use Awakened Swift Affliction, which is going to shorten these durations. The amulet has life, resistances, intelligence and plus 1 level of all physical skill gems. We also anoint Growth and Decay. Now, physical damage over time multiplier is also a pretty nice suffix to have, but I will only advise chasing it if you Awakener slam two amulets together. Having said that, I've got Aspect of the Spider here, and this skill is mandatory anywhere you can craft it. Just don't put it in the body armor because it is going to scale with the gems you socket in there and it'll become unusable. One of the rings has vulnerability on hit as the implicit, alongside life and resistances. If possible, try to craft increased damage, which is a prefix. The other ring has life, resists, increased damage from Leo Unveils and a minimum frenzy charge. The belt is a Stygian Vise with life, resists and the enchantment, enemies maimed take 8% increased damage over time. The Abyss Jewel has life, some intelligence and damage over time while holding a shield. The gloves have life, physical damage over time multiplier, a resist and we craft elemental ailment avoidance chance. The boots have life, resists, movement speed and elemental ailment avoidance chance. And for flasks, Rami's Concoction, a Basalt Flask and a Sulfur Flask. Remember that Chaos Resistance is mandatory everywhere and anywhere that you can get some. I built my character with elemental ailment avoidance in mind, which is why I focused some of the suffixes towards that goal. But if you don't want that, feel free to ignore those modifiers. All in all, I don't think that the gear is super special, but you'll be the judge for that. So now, let us talk about the passives. Alright, so this is a level 94 Gladiator. We sided with no bandits and for Pantheons, Lunaris or Solaris depending on the situation and Shakari or Avarath, again, depending on the situation. For the Ascendancy, we go right side for the physical damage over time stuff while also grabbing the left side for equal amounts of spell and attack block chance. Simple stuff. Now for the tree itself, at one point I had specced the build towards the shadow area. The thing is, a couple of cluster jewels outgunned that side, so instead we are gonna focus on the strength side of the skill tree. But first, we are gonna grab the crystal skin cluster. And alongside the mods on our gear, this is going to make us immune to chill, freeze, ignite and shock. If you don't care about elemental elements or prefer relying on flask suffixes, feel free to ignore these choices altogether. Also, be sure to grab any life node in the way because we need at least 6000 HP since Corrupting Fever is going to roughly cost 5900 HP to cast, so we gotta be healthy. Anyways, we're gonna need some duration because the Corrupting Fever debuff and buff need to last as long as possible, and we also want the physical damage over time nodes near the Zion area and between Templar and Marauder. The first large cluster jewel goes in this area, an 8 passive chunker, with Master the Fundamentals and Exploit Weakness. We only take 5 passives in this jewel. Now for the medium clusters, one of them has Rend and Flow of Life. The other jewel has Blood Artist as the sole notable that we care about. In a perfect world scenario, we get both jewels with Flow of Life and Blood Artist, but this combination is a bit expensive, so instead we go with my current loadout. On the way to the other cluster jewel socket, we take Resolute Technique, so that we cannot miss with a Spectral Shield Throw, you know, to guarantee the stacks of Corrupting Fever. We also take Vitality Extraction on the way for a bit more damage. The other cluster jewel setup is pretty much the same setup as above, but we gotta take the 3 notables in this large cluster jewel, because the last node is Furious Assault, as it gives us a bit of physical damage and attack speed, which is gonna help Spectral Shield Throw's fire rate. Now for the jewels, we use a Divide and Conquer to make a Spectral Shield Throw chain. The rest of the rare jewels have increased maximum life and physical damage over time multiplier as the mandatory modifiers, alongside either attack speed, chance to block attack damage, attributes or even more damage. Up to you. But yeah, that is it for the skill tree. And I am sure that there is probably a cleaner route to take. But for this build, this one worked just fine. So now let us talk about the gem setups. Alright, in the body armor, Corrupting Fever, Link to Empower, Life Tap, Brutality, Anomalous Efficacy and Awakened Swift Affliction. In the gloves, Enduring Cry and Flame Dash, both Link to Second Wind and Anomalous Life Tap. In the helmet, Divergent Spectral Shield Throw, Link to Anomalous Life Tap, Faster Attacks and Anomalous Maim. In the shield, Phantasmal Ancestral Protector and Tempest Shield, with both linked to Anomalous Life Tap. And finally, in the boots, Divergent Pride, War Banner and Herald of Purity, linked to Enlighten. Before we wrap this one up, do not link Corrupting Fever to Anomalous Life Tap. This variant of Life Tap makes life costs a bit more expensive. The reason as to why we link everything else to this is to make it easier on us to maintain Corrupting Fever, by continuously spending life. If you link Corrupting Fever to it, you'll make the skill cost even more life, to the point where you won't have enough health points to cast it again, so be careful in that sense. Now with that said, let us wrap up this build. I gotta say, this one was a pretty fun character to play with. We didn't see as much ultimatum action on the previous characters because it was not a very smooth experience on those. Unlike those builds, however, this guy handles the league mechanic with relative ease, as you're seeing from the gameplay. Corrupting Fever, like the other physical damage over time spells, goes through proximity shields, which is going to make this far smoother than the regular Spectral Shield Throw gladiators that we've seen in the channel before. That little detail alone makes this one a lot more enjoyable. However, it is a bit of a stressful build, in the sense that we're gonna maintain Corrupting Fever. This implies using Enduring Cry to heal after the initial cast to not waste a charge of the life flask. We gotta spam skills continuously to maintain the uptime of Corrupting Fever, and we also gotta build up stacks of it during single target, you know, for DPS purposes. It is not a one-click, one-skill build, which is going to throw some of you off, but if you can look past that, you're in for a treat. Having said all of this, almost every piece of equipment can be improved. Really, the reason I didn't push harder was because I ran out of currency. Granted, I've gotten a Stormbrand Assassin's worth of gear on the other character that has not been traded away, so I did put myself in this hard position with this one. But in the end, it doesn't really matter because the build did fine anyways. Except on Sirius, because sometimes the fucker doesn't wanna cooperate. You know how he is. But yeah, that's gonna be it for me today. I leave you with Maven's fight. Thank you so much for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, but a rating and a comment are also appreciated. Take care, have a nice start to your week, and peace out.
Hey. they returned tenfold.
Is growing. This will not be an escape.
Resisting.
Still.